Want to speak real French from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at FrenchPod101.com.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to another episode of Top Words. Today, we'll be talking about five amazing love quotes from French songs. Let's go. Je l'aime à mourir by Francis Cabrel. I love her so much, I could die. Je l'aime à mourir is a song by Francis Cabrel released in 1979. The album sold more than 600,000 copies in France, and the song remains the biggest single of Francis Cabrel. Obviously, it's a love song. It's about a man who is deeply in love with a woman who transformed his life. The song is really poetic and full of imagery. For example, it says that he likes to spend time with her so much that he lost track of time. Les amoureux des bancs publics by Georges Brassens. The lovers on public benches. This famous song has been written and sang by the no less famous Georges Brassens. He was inspired by Raymond René, a French cartoonist known for having created Les Amoureux, The Lovers, which he presented on many mediums. The song is smart, funny, and you can feel that Brassens looks at the lovers with a friendly eye. La Vie en Rose by Edith Piaf. Life in Pink. The song's title can be translated in various ways. For example, Life in Rosy Hose, or Life Through Rose-Tinted Glasses, but its literal meaning is Life in Pink. It is one of the most famous French songs. Written and sang by Edith Piaf, it refers to the state of joy that love puts you in. When you are deeply in love, everything appears bright and cheerful. Released after the war, the song La Vie en Rose made Piaf internationally famous. The most famous quote of this song is from the chorus. L'été indien by Joe Dassin. Indian Summer. Indian Summer is a song performed by Joe Dassin, released in 1975. This song is the greatest success of his career. It sold 950,000 copies in France and almost 2 million copies worldwide. The song was released in 25 countries and was translated into several languages. It's about a man who recalls the good old days from the past. In particular, a magic moment he spent with his love when they were visiting the USA. Pourquoi tu m'aimes encore by Céline Dion. So that you love me again. Pourquoi tu m'aimes encore is a song made famous by Céline Dion. It was written and composed by Jean-Jacques Goldman, a French lyricist and singer. The song was the most played song on French radio stations in the year 1995. The song is about a woman who wants her love back and is ready to do anything for it. Okay, that's the end of this topic. Do you know any of these French songs? Do you have a favorite French song? Leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe and visit FrenchPod101.com for more great French content. À bientôt!
Ah, maybe first you can pretend like you know the person from somewhere, okay? That always works.
Nice to meet you.
Hey! Wait, that's English.
Yeah.
Hola, Maca. M'han dit que et dius Anja? És correcte?
Very sexy inside.
Yeah.
Mexican?
No,
Mexican sounds good.
Is it Spanish?
No.
No.
Va, que llegiré una frase. D'acord?
Yes.
Portuguese? No.
So maybe it's Spain. Spanish, like.
It's in Spain.
How do they say it? Maybe I don't know how to say in English. Catalanese?
Yeah.
Really?
Catalan.
Oh, really?
Hola. ¿Cómo estás?
Hola, Max. ¿Cómo estás?
La verdad es que te iba a tirar un chamuyo barato, pero te vi los ojos y no sé, te quiero invitar a salir, te quiero para algo serio.
La verdad que no soy de hacer estas cosas, es raro en mí. Pero desde el momento en el que te vi,
Estoy sintiendo cosas que antes no sentía. No sé qué me está pasando. Y no sé si es tu voz o tu sonrisa, pero me parece que tenemos que ir a tomar algo juntos. Así que lo que voy a hacer es darte mi número de teléfono. Me vas a escribir. Tal vez nos vamos a enamorar. No sé. Veremos qué pasa. ¿Está bien?
No sé.
I know.
Wow. This is like love confession.
I have to admit that it was like kind of romantic, like the pronunciation and stuff. Mm-hmm. But like, yeah, the content is a bit cheesy. Yeah. Ah, sorry about that.
Is it Spanish language, right?
I don't know. You think so?
Yeah.
Es castellano, exactamente.
我喜欢跟你在一起的感觉。我能请你喝杯东西吗？你怎么那么可爱？
It was so sudden.
This is easy.
Are you willing to come to my place afterwards? Yeah, just like to be kind of like spice things up a bit.
Like it's Mandarin.
Yes.
How come you know?
I've got a lot of Chinese friends.
Aww.
라면먹고갈래?
Okay.
Yeah. This is obvious for me.
It means, do you want to drop by my house and eat instant noodle with me?
This sounds like something like Chinese or Vietnamese to me.
Do you really use it? I mean, well, or it's just like...
This line is from a movie, so actually everyone knows. Yeah, ta.
That's it.
Yeah, ta.
Korean, right?
Okay, so let's say Korean.
But please remember this line. Okay. 라면 먹고 갈래?
라면 먹고 갈래?
This line is usually used by female.
Oh.
So it's like, I will
try. Today I will try.
Yeah. 라면 먹고갈래?
라면먹고갈래?
Yeah.
どこかでお会いしたことありますか?
ないと思います。
今度一緒にご飯でもどうですか?
まだ食べた。
まだ食べた。It means no, maybe. I didn't expect the answer.
It was like one way. Japanese.
僕が必ず君を守るから。
Oh, I got excited.
And now I get really shy because she understands.
I understand you.
It means like I'm going to protect you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, they don't say in real world.
Yeah. But sometimes you just see drama. In drama. Yeah, drama. But it's too romantic,
yeah.
I think.
I want to give a message from here to the world. Mm-hmm. Don't watch so much drama. Come and experience real life first, right?
That's true.
Du är så vacker. Så det ger solen en anledning att skina.
Wow.
Wow. This one is hard.
You're so beautiful. You give the sun a reason to shine.
Wow.
It doesn't look like something European or... I feel like it might be indie.
Oh, yeah, this is a good one. Dina läppar smakar som vin och ikväll vill jag bli berusad.
Okay, like it looks so different to me right now. Like I feel like it's something European right now and like something Germanic, but not German.
And,
what's the letter it starts with?
The letter it starts with?
Yeah.
S.
Okay. So, can you say it again? This one?
Yeah, yeah.
Not because I like the compliment.
Yeah. I'll say it as many times as you like. Om det hade varit kriminellt att vara snygg, hade du fått livstid.
Okay, this is like something European because I hear no criminal.
Du är så, you said, right?
Du är så.
Du är så. Is it a European language?
Yes.
Swedish?
Holy cow.
Swedish, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, because I have friends from Sweden.
Ah.
Hello again.
Oh, you're a beautiful girl.
You are a girl.
Well, I thought it was a girl.
What, really?
Hello.
Oh, hello.
Hey. Oh, difficult.
Usually I've got some bad stereotypes about, like, Spanish, but the Spanish one was quite good, I think. But that's not the winner. To me, like, okay, I think it was Korean, mainly because I couldn't understand, like, what it meant.
I don't know, I just think Spanish sounds maybe the most sexiest of the languages I've heard today. Yeah, I didn't know much of Catalan. The sound of that, and that was really nice as well.
Now, since my husband is Korean, Korean was attractive, I think, because that's why maybe I fell in love with him, right? But also, it's really hard to decide because Castellano and also the Canton language, it sounds also very attractive. I don't know, maybe it's because of their tonation. I don't know why, but even though I don't know the meaning, it sounds like very natural, very confident. So I like that language too.
Bonjour tout le monde, je m'appelle Ingrid. Connaissez-vous la Saint-Valentin? Il s'agit de la fête des amoureux que les Français célèbrent le 14 février. En France, cette fête s'adresse uniquement aux couples. Dans cette leçon, nous allons apprendre pourquoi et de quelle façon nous fêtons la Saint-Valentin. Connaissez-vous l'illustrateur français qui s'est fait connaître grâce à des dessins de couples d'amoureux? Nous allons vous montrer la réponse à la fin de cette vidéo. La Saint-Valentin est d'origine païenne. Les Romains fêtaient Lupercus, le dieu de la fécondité. Plus tard, le pape Gélase, en 498, fixe le 14 février comme le jour de la fête des Saint-Valentin en l'honneur des trois martyrs prénommés Valentin. Mais les historiens ignorent encore aujourd'hui pourquoi la fête de l'amour a été associée avec ces trois martyrs. La Saint-Valentin, telle qu'on la connaît aujourd'hui en France, arrive au XVe siècle grâce à Charles d'Orléans, qui a pris connaissance de cette fête alors qu'il était prisonnier en Angleterre. En France, chaque année, la Saint-Valentin fait débat. Il y a ceux qui sont pour et ceux qui sont contre. Cette fête est souvent critiquée car vue comme purement commerciale. De plus, les célibataires se sentent stigmatisés. Durant cette période, les journalistes rédigent des articles afin de donner leur opinion sur cette fête, tout comme les animateurs radio ou télé. Tous les Français en parlent et tout le monde donne son avis. Néanmoins, cette fête connaît un grand succès. De nombreux magasins sont décorés avec du rouge et du rose, les couleurs de l'amour. D'après les sondages, plus de la moitié des Français déclarent célébrer la Saint-Valentin. Généralement, les couples s'offrent des week-ends ou des voyages à deux. Le parfum est également un cadeau très prisé. Les roses rouges sont quant à elles l'élément décoration indispensable. En France, il existe un village qui s'appelle Saint-Valentin. De nombreux touristes français, mais également chinois ou japonais, viennent y célébrer la fête des couples. Les participants peuvent recevoir un diplôme des amoureux remis en main propre par le maire de la commune. Et maintenant, je vais vous donner la réponse du quiz vu plus tôt. Connaissez-vous l'illustrateur français qui s'est fait connaître grâce à ses dessins de couples d'amoureux ? Raymond Penet est un dessinateur français renommé, né en 1908 et mort en 1999. Ce sont ses dessins de couples d'amoureux qui l'ont rendu célèbre. Aujourd'hui encore, on peut les retrouver sur de nombreux supports, comme des cartes ou des timbres. Comment était cette leçon? Avez-vous appris des choses intéressantes? Et vous, célébrez-vous la Saint-Valentin ou jugez-vous cette fête trop commerciale? Laissez-nous un commentaire sur frenchpod11.com et à très bientôt.
Want to speak real French from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at frenchpod101.com.
Does having a study partner help you learn a language faster? For most people, having a friend or romantic partner who is a native speaker of their target language dramatically improves their ability to master the language. In this video, we'll talk about some ways to help you build relationships with people. We'll also talk about three reasons having a native speaker partner can improve your language fluency. First, knowing a native speaker helps you better understand the culture. Knowing a native speaker gets you connected with the culture in ways that no lessons or textbooks ever could. Native speakers are better informed about the latest slang expressions and know interesting places to eat and hang out. Having a friend or partner who is a native speaker can dramatically improve your understanding of the language. In addition to language, you can learn about cultural practices, gestures, and relationships. Second, having a native speaker partner increases your exposure to the language. Practice makes perfect is a well-known expression that is certainly true for language learning. When you have a friend, romantic partner, or study buddy, you speak to them through text messages, phone calls, and basic interaction. These are all opportunities for you to practice the language. Making an effort to practice will help your vocabulary quickly expand beyond simple greetings, flirtatious words, and basic comments to deeper, more meaningful conversations. Third, a supportive partner is the best study aid you can find. We all make mistakes, especially when trying to learn a new language. But if you have a supportive partner, they can gently point out your mistakes and help you find better ways to express yourself. And if your native speaker study partner is also your romantic partner, your motivation will likely be even higher than someone who does not have a romantic relationship with a native speaker. Now, let's look at three ways our language learning program helps you learn even faster if you have a native speaker partner. First, all resources and materials are available in English and in your target language. Studying with a partner is special because it's an opportunity for both of you to learn a new language. That's why every single lesson, transcript, vocabulary list, and resource on our website is available in English and in your target language. You can learn from each other. Second, lessons are designed to help you understand and engage with culture. On our website, our focus is to help our students learn practical vocabulary and phrases that are actually used in everyday conversation. This means that from your very first lesson, you can start applying what you learn immediately. So if you want to go out to a restaurant, play games, or attend a social function with your partner, you'll have the vocabulary and phrases necessary to have a great time. Third, access to special resources dedicated to romantic phrases. If your study partner is your romantic partner, we have resources to help you communicate your feelings correctly. Our language learning program has special sections and tools to teach you love words, phrases, and cultural insights. Of course, please remember that simply being in a relationship is no substitute for studying. Communication is key to every relationship, whether romantic or not. If you fail to continue expanding your vocabulary and you stop learning the language on your own, your relationships may suffer or fizzle out. Without question, spending time with native speakers can help you dramatically improve your language proficiency. But this is no replacement for focused studying. It's essential to help facilitate better communication and master the language. So, if you're ready to finally learn a new language the fast, fun, and easy way, sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Signing up takes less than 30 seconds, and you'll start speaking from your very first lesson. If you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye! Being able to speak freely with native speakers is an amazing ability in itself. But being able to speak freely to a whole new group of people opens you up to possible new relationships. Most people don't realize that spending the time to build relationships in a foreign language can actually help you improve your language skills dramatically. In this video, we look at how making relationships in a foreign language can help you learn the language faster. The benefits of having friends and partners who speak a foreign language. First, it's motivational. One of the greatest struggles for anyone learning a second language is motivation. 9 times out of 10, learners start out their language learning journey with loads of enthusiasm, only to see it gradually wane over time. Try as they may, it's difficult to maintain the spark they once shared with their new language. So why not borrow energy from a different part of your life? When you make relationships with people in your target language, all the excitement of a new relationship carries directly over into your learning. Suddenly, you have a very rewarding reason to improve your skills and keep practicing. As your partner or your friends get involved, you will also have the advantage of a constant source of support and encouragement. Second, it makes language learning practical. Studying vocabulary and grammar is a vital part of language learning, whether you use a podcast, textbook, app, or find yourself in a classroom. However, as great as studying is, a language really only starts to come alive once you start using it in everyday life. There's a huge difference between a scripted conversation in a lesson plan and a real-life conversation with a native speaker. Building relationships with native speakers will give you the chance to talk in your target language often. Furthermore, it will be in a way that feels natural. You'll learn the words in the context, which is hugely important. Third, it's fun. One of the greatest benefits is that it allows you to practice without having it feel like practice. Oftentimes, you'll find yourself so wrapped up in the conversation that you forget you're using a foreign language. This takes a lot of the pressure off and helps you focus on communication over trying to speak absolutely perfectly. You also get to learn about a whole new culture from your partner or friends. So you're not only learning language skills, but also about the cultures that surround your target language. The risks of having friends and partners who speak a foreign language. First, it's easy to miscommunicate. When it comes to relationships, humans can easily misunderstand each other. So it can be hard when building relationships in your target language when you or your partner's lack of ability in each other's respective native tongue can lead to miscommunications that would otherwise be avoidable. Depending on the language you're speaking, a simple mistranslation or mispronounced word can drastically change the meaning of a sentence. As long as you can afford each other some extra patience and the benefit of the doubt, then you should be able to overcome this pitfall. Second, your language skills could suffer if your relationships don't work out. If all your language practice is wrapped up in one person and your relationship with that person doesn't work out, then your language learning could take a big hit. So it's best not to put all your hopes for language growth on one area, relationship or otherwise. You don't want to risk losing motivation, so try to find it in many different areas. An idea for building relationships in a foreign language. Make games out of getting to know one another. Sometimes, opening up in any new friendship or partnership can be hard. Add in the added struggle of a new language, and it can feel impossible to share your true feelings with others. So instead of trying to take first interactions so seriously and talking about the usual things like the weather or work, try to ask new, interesting questions. Try to figure out what the other person's hobbies are without asking directly, or what kind of job they have. This will give you a chance to stretch your language skills in a new way, and you'll probably get some funny answers out of it too. Being comfortable being silly or making language mistakes is a great way to bond with someone, even if you've just met. Relationships in a foreign language have a lot more benefits to offer than drawbacks. Don't be scared to open up to people and make mistakes. And for even more help to build relationships in your target language, check out our complete language learning program. Sign up for your free lifetime account by clicking on the link in the description. Get tons of resources to have you speaking in your target language. And if you enjoyed these tips, hit the like button, share the video with anyone who's trying to learn a new language, and subscribe to our channel. We release new videos every week. I'll see you next time. Bye.
Hi, everyone. I'm Leah from FrenchPod101.com. Do you know how to say I love you in French? In this lesson, you will learn three different ways to say I love you and a special phrase for Valentine's Day. Let's go! So the most normal way to confess to someone you do know would be je t'aime, je t'aime, je t'aime, I love you. This phrase is direct. You should use it only when confessing your love. If you want to be less direct, you can use this phrase. Tu comptes tant pour moi. Tu comptes tant pour moi. It means you mean so much to me.
Tu comptes tant pour moi.
Now, if you want to be more romantic in expressing your love for someone, you can say this phrase. Les mots ne peuvent pas décrire mon amour pour toi. Les mots ne peuvent pas décrire mon amour pour toi. It means words can't describe my love for you.
Cheesy.
Now you know three different ways to say I love you in French. And here is one more. What if you want to spend Valentine's Day with someone special? In that case, say this phrase. If it's a girl, you can say, veux-tu être ma Valentine? And if it's a boy, you can say, veux-tu être mon Valentin? Will you be my Valentine? Veux-tu être ma Valentine? Veux-tu être mon Valentin? If you want to ask formally, you can say, voulez-vous être mon Valentin? Or, voulez-vous être ma Valentine? Let's wrap up this lesson by recapping what we've learned. Listen to the expression and repeat after me. I love you. Je t'aime. Je t'aime. You mean so much to me. Tu comptes tant pour moi. Tu comptes tant pour moi. Words can describe my love for you. Les mots ne peuvent pas décrire mon amour pour toi. Les mots ne peuvent pas décrire mon amour pour toi. Will you be my Valentine? Veux-tu être ma Valentine? Or, veux-tu être mon Valentin? Veux-tu être ma Valentine? Or, veux-tu être mon Valentin? Well done! Did you know that on Valentine's Day, many shops in France are decorated in red or rouge and pink or rose? Couples also give each other weekends away or trips to take together. Perfume is also a very popular gift on Valentine's Day. You just learned how to say I love you in three different ways in French and a special phrase for Valentine's Day.
I touched my mic. Welcome back, watchers! This week we are going to talk about 10 breakup lines. Why are we being so mean lately? Let's start. Ce n'est pas toi, c'est moi. It's not you, it's me. Ce n'est pas toi, c'est moi. Liars, liars everywhere. Of course it's not myself, it's you, obviously. J'ai besoin de me concentrer sur ma carrière. I need to focus on my career. J'ai besoin de me concentrer sur ma carrière. And your lover be like, you only love your job and not me. J'ai besoin de mon espace. I need my space. J'ai besoin de mon espace. I need my space. Ah, that's harsh. Je ne suis simplement pas prête pour ce genre de relation. I'm just not ready for this kind of relationship. Je ne suis simplement pas prête pour ce genre de relation. I'm just not ready for this kind of relationship. Then don't start one! I don't know if you're not ready for this, just don't start it all together. Je pense que nous avons besoin d'une pause. I think we need a break. Je pense que nous avons besoin d'une pause. I think we need a break. So yeah, you know when you are on a break, it will last forever, right? So, just get over it and go away, because it doesn't work to fix the relationship again anyway. Soyons seulement amis. Let's just be friends. Soyons seulement amis. Let's just be friends. You just got friendzoned.
Let's just be friends.
Tu mérites mieux. You deserve better. Tu mérites mieux. You deserve better. This is also a lie. You are just trying to make the other person feel good. They are the one not deserving you. That's why you're breaking up, right? I deserve better. Je mérite mieux. It's a way more accurate sentence of what you're really thinking about. Je ne suis pas assez bien pour toi. I'm not good enough for you. Which is basically the same as previous one. But putting the blame on yourself.
Oh, I'm not good enough. You should go away.
Of course you're good enough, or else why are you the one breaking up? Nous ne sommes tout simplement pas faits l'un pour l'autre. We are just not right for each other. Nous ne sommes tout simplement pas faits l'un pour l'autre. We are just not right for each other. This one is kinda true, that works. This is honest. Yeah, it doesn't work, then it doesn't work. Please go away now. Je ne t'aime plus, tout simplement. I just don't love you anymore. Je ne t'aime plus, tout simplement. I just don't love you anymore. Harsh! So harsh! Bye-bye. Go away. So, watchers, we'll see you next time. And meanwhile, practice your breakup. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos and check the website for more lists and more mean words and how to be mean or nice sometimes we are nice. Bye-bye. I'm going away on an adventure and you cannot follow me because it's dangerous. Wow. Je pars pour une aventure et tu ne peux pas me suivre car c'est trop dangereux. Yeah, use this one and then disappear.
Huh. Is everyone feeling in love?
I'm Leah and here are our 10 most romantic ideas for a date. Let's go on a date together.
Dîner aux chandelles. Candlelit dinner. Dîner aux chandelles. Candlelit dinner. J'ai préparé un dîner aux chandelles pour notre anniversaire de mariage.
I prepared a candlelit dinner for our wedding anniversary.
That's a romantic thing to do. And then you put tiny paper hearts and you put dim lights. Everything is nice. A nice bottle of wine or champagne. That's cute.
Faire une longue promenade. To go for a long walk. Faire une longue promenade. To go for a long walk. Nous avons fait une longue promenade après le déjeuner.
We went for a long walk after lunch.
Yeah, I should do that too after lunch.
You can go to a nice park and watch the trees and the flowers and just hold hands in the park and break everything.
Aller faire du bowling. To go bowling. Aller faire du bowling. To go bowling. Nous sommes allés faire du bowling pour mon anniversaire.
We went bowling for my birthday. If a guy is asking you to go bowling on a date, it's because he wants to look at your butt when you clumsily throw the ball.
So bowling is a common French idea of a date. So a lot of people do that apparently.
So yeah, if you are the one inviting for the date, you should make a big score and show how strong you are. And if you are the one invited or if you want to act all cute, you should be a bit clumsy and say, can you help me? I don't know how to hold the ball properly. It's so heavy. And yeah, be a bit clumsy, that's cute.
The best is if you look a bit clumsy, but then you beat your date. And that's the fun part. And you say, aha, and they will love you even more.
Aller à l'aquarium. To go to the aquarium. Aller à l'aquarium. To go to the aquarium. Elle n'est jamais allée à l'aquarium. She has never been to the aquarium.
Aquarium are nice for a date because it's a bit dark and you see all the pretty fishes swimming around. It's really relaxing and cozy and intimate, so that's a good idea. Hey, I can be positive sometimes.
Aller à l'opéra. To go to the opera. Aller à l'opéra. To go to the opera. Mes grands-parents adorent aller à l'opéra.
My grandparents love going to the opera. That's your grandparents' date? If you want to go for a date, you can feel sophisticated and smart.
Faire un pique-nique. To have a picnic. Faire un pique-nique. To have a picnic. Je vais faire un pique-nique au parc avec mes amis le mois prochain.
I will have a picnic at the park with my friends next month. You have homemade lunch, maybe nice sandwiches, some glasses of maybe sparkly wine. That's fancy for a picnic and that's kind of nice. And you just enjoy the nature together.
Dîner et voir un film. To have dinner and see a movie. Dîner et voir un film. To have dinner and see a movie. Hier soir, nous avons dîné et vu un film.
Yesterday evening, we had dinner and saw a movie. That's also a common date practice where you go to a nice restaurant and then you make sure to finish on time and go to a late viewing at the cinema. Then you're all cozy and warm and you fall a bit asleep because it's dark and the food was nice. And then you can rest on the shoulder of your date like this.
Prendre un ferry. To take a ferry ride. Prendre un ferry. To take a ferry ride. Nous avons pris le ferry d'Irlande en Écosse.
We took a ferry ride from Ireland to Scotland. If you have a ferry available, it can be a nice date opportunity. You're on the sea, you can see the infinite water in front of you, feel the breeze, imitate the Titanic pose. Why not? And some ferries are so big they even have casino and movie theaters inside, so that can complete your date.
Casino. Marcher sur la plage. To walk on the beach. Marcher sur la plage. To walk on the beach. J'aime marcher sur la plage.
I like to walk on the beach.
I like that too. And then you can hold hands again and draw messages in the sand, make tiny hearts, just sit and look at the ocean, feel the breeze again. Aller au musée, to go to the museum. Aller au musée, go to the museum. If you want to feel smart and the opera wasn't enough, you can go to the museum, like before the opera. Il aime aller au musée pendant des heures. He likes going to the museum for hours. And you can sit together and stare at romantic paintings of couple in the grass. And it goes for a quiet date and a smart one. And then you feel nice about yourself and you can talk about your feelings while looking at all the art. And it's the end. Tell me what's your fun idea for a date in the comments. And if you want more love and date and that kind of vocabulary, don't forget to check the website or subscribe to the channel because we have more videos about this. And we will see you next time. I hope we will see you again after the date. Bye, everyone.
Great work. Here's a reward. Speed up your language learning with our PDF lessons. Get all of our best PDF cheat sheets and ebooks for free. Just click the link in the description.